The U.S. Space Force is preparing a series of groundbreaking tests aimed at demonstrating satellite refueling technologies directly in orbit. These upcoming trials, known as Tetra-5 and Tetra-6, are scheduled for 2026 and 2027, respectively. They represent a crucial step forward in the development of the commercial orbital servicing sector. Several key industry players are involved in the project: Astroscale, Northrop Grumman, and Orbit Fab, each working on building the infrastructure needed to extend the lifespan of satellites in space. Originally conceived as a single experimental initiative with a $44.5 million budget, the program was later split into two distinct phases. In the Tetra-5 mission, two small satellites developed by Orbit Fab will be launched into orbit. One will test docking procedures with a fuel depot built in collaboration with the Defense Innovation Unit, while the other will trial interactions with a refueling module developed by Astroscale. A year later, Tetra-6 will take off. Its primary objective is to test the PRM module designed by Northrop Grumman. This module will attempt to dock with the Rooster 5 orbital tanker, which is based on the ESPA Star D platform. If successful, this experiment will pave the way for the development of a full-scale orbital refueling system called GAST, aimed at servicing satellites in geostationary orbit. The program's goal isn't just to validate the technical reliability of these new systems in space. It also aims to assess the economic feasibility of such services for private companies without heavy reliance on government funding. According to the U.S. Space Force, the success of Tetra-5 could lay the groundwork for building a scalable satellite refueling network in orbit. The report emphasizes that establishing this kind of infrastructure could revolutionize satellite operations, extending their mission lifespans, increasing maneuverability, and reducing the frequency of costly replacements. But before that vision can become a reality, these technologies must first prove themselves in real-world conditions. The outcomes of these experiments will determine whether in-orbit logistics can evolve into a viable standalone sector within the space industry.